In the last video, all of our rsync examples copied files from the source to the destination, but the files were not really synced. What I mean by that is, if there are more files in the destination directory, they stayed in the destination directory, so it did not really sync the source to the destination. It just copied the source to the destination. If we deleted a file from the source directory and rsync the directory the way we learned in the last video, the deleted file will still be in that destination directory. And there are times when we want that action to happen, but there are also times when we want the destination directory to be an exact match of the source directory. And if a file is removed from the source directory, we want to remove that file from the destination directory. I'm going to add a few files to our DST directory with touch DST extrafile1.txt and extrafile2.txt. And now I will rsync the source to the destination with rsync -av src dst --dry run. Rsync shows us there's nothing to sync because all the files in the src directory match the files in the DST directory. But we also have the two new files in the DST directory. To truly sync the source directory to the destination directory, after copying the source to the destination, we will also want to delete out any files in the destination that are not in the source directory. We can do that by adding in --delete to our rsync command. Pressing enter. Now we see it will delete out those two extra files from the destination directory that are not in the source directory. And then removing the dry run and running this command deletes them out. And we'll show this by running the dry run again. And now there are no files to sync. In this tutorial series, we haven't talked about logging into other computers with SSH. But since rsync uses SSH to sync files to another computer, we'll take an introductory look at SSH right now. I have added another computer to my local network. And when I say local network, I mean behind my router to the internet. The computer I set up has a local IP address of 192.168.1.42. I have created a Michael user on that computer. I have enabled SSH on that computer, and rsync is installed on that computer. I am going to open a new tab, and I'm going to make this a light tab, just so we can keep the two tabs straight. And on this lighter tab, I'm going to SSH into that other computer. To SSH in, I will type SSH Michael at 192.168.1.42. So Michael is the user ID that I created on that computer, and we're telling SSH that the IP address we're looking for is 192.168.1.42. Pressing enter, it's asking me for the password for Michael on the 192.168.1.42 computer. So I'll type that in. And now it shows us that we're logged into the other computer, and that computer is called TESTSRVR. I'm going to clear the screen and type pwd and ls-lh to show that we have no files in the home Michael directory on this computer. Going back to the other tab, I want to rsync the grocerylist.txt file that's inside the source directory to the other computer. To do that, I will start the rsync command just as we've seen, rsync -av. src grocerylist.txt. And then for our destination, we need to start that off with the same information we used when we SSH'd into the other computer. So I will type Michael at 192.168.1.42, and then a colon, and then the directory on that computer where we want this to go. That will be /home/Michael. Pressing enter. Rsync is asking us for the Michael password on the 192.168.1.42 computer. and it shows us the file was copied. Let's go over to the other tab and type ls-lh, and we do see the grocerylist.txt file did get copied over to this computer. Going back to the other tab, the way we copy the file is called a push. The file was on the same computer that we submitted the rsync command, so we pushed it to a different computer. The other way is to pull a file or files from another computer to the computer I'm running the rsync command on. Typing ls-lh shows us that we do not have the grocerylist.txt file in this directory, so we're going to pull it from the other computer to this directory. I'm going to do that by typing rsync-av. Now I need my server details, starting with Michael, then the at symbol, and then we're using the IP address to identify that server. So I'll type in 192.168.1.42, then a colon, and now I'm adding the tilde, which we saw in earlier videos means go to the home directory, and in that home directory, we're looking for the file grocerylist.txt. Now we need to give it a destination directory, and we want to give the directory that we are in. So I'm just going to press the dot or period. So we're telling rsync to log in to the 192.168.1.42 computer as Michael, go to the home directory and find the file grocerylist.txt and sync that to this directory. Pressing enter. It's asking me for the password. And now the rsync command is telling us it synced the file grocerylist.txt, and we can also see that by typing ls-lh. And in this case, we see that it worked both ways, both pushing and pulling the files. In the past, I have had troubles with rsync pulling files, in which case I just logged into the other computer and pushed the files. In other words, what I'm saying is if it doesn't work one way, try the other. I have a larger file in the parent directory that I'm going to move into this directory with move from the parent directory, larger file.tar.xz, and I want to move that right here. And there we see the larger file, and I'm going to rsync this over to our other computer. To do that, I'm going to type rsync-av larger file.tar.xz. And I want to rsync that as the Michael user at 192.168.1.42. And I want to put that in the home Michael directory. Pressing enter, it's asking me for the password. And I'm going to cancel out of that. And the reason I'm canceling out is because we don't see how much of that file is being copied over to the other computer. To see how much of that file is rsynced, I'm going to add the uppercase P option to our command. That uppercase P does two things. Number one is progress. It shows us how much of the file is rsynced. And number two is partial. If the rsync fails for some reason, rsync can keep what is partially moved over there and just pick up from where it left off. In other words, if you're rsyncing a large file that maybe took hours to rsync and only has a little bit more to go, if that job fails for some reason, when you restart the rsync command with that uppercase P option, it will pick up from where it left off and just have those last few minutes and won't have to start over from the beginning. So when you're rsyncing large files, you'll want to use that uppercase P option. Pressing enter again and then putting in my password. And here we see the percentage of the files being copied over to the other computer. Our rsync is done. Let's go over to the other tab and type ls-lh. And there we see the larger file.tar.xz is there, as well as the grocerylist.txt. There are many more options for the rsync command that we did not look at in this tutorial. Things like excluding files and directories, or telling rsync to keep the ACL permissions. Going over all the options would be a tutorial series in itself. These two videos on rsync are enough to get you started with some of the most common features of the rsync command. In the next video, we'll continue looking at the Linux command line.